Good morning, everyone. Three ways filters are going to change your life forever. Let's go. All right, guys, I hope you're having an amazing day. Welcome to a new episode in the middle of nowhere in Arizona today. I want to talk to you about filters, how it changed my life, how it's gonna change yours, at least, or photographers or videographers' life. And the reason why I'm doing this video is simply because I never really understood how to use them, why I should carry them. This just seemed bulky and useless until recently, I would say 1 or 2 years ago, I actually started using those kind of filters, the circular ones, and it totally changed my photography and my life. So let's get right into it, right here, right now. It's gonna be 3 Minute Thursday. No, I'm just kidding. I have to stop that joke. Let's go, let's get started. There are so many filters available on the market, guys. There are different types, ND, polarizing, mist, UV filters. They all serve different purposes. Now, there are two that I use mainly, and I wanna share with you exactly why those ones are the ones that really changed my life and how. So the reason number one is simply because with a filter, and specifically a polarizing filter, you're able to cut out completely the reflection from the water. Guys, if you have been following what I'm creating, you know I was supposed to shoot that video in a canyon to show you a great example, but whenever you're turning that polarizing filter, you're able to cut out the reflection from the water, which is absolutely amazing. Here's an example. I was on the drone flying over a kayak, and I'm able to completely cut out the reflection that's coming from the sun, which means I can see through the water into the coral reefs. It's absolutely insane. Look at the difference with and without. It's day and night. If this was not enough with polarizing filter, guys, there's something I didn't know. I just couldn't understand how the photographers were getting those deep dark blues that were just so crispy and beautiful, and those colors that were deep. I just didn't understand how it was happening. Even in post-production, I could get close to it, but it was never the same, like, natural feeling until I screwed on the polarizing filter. I looked at the sky and then I turned it on, and look at that magic. This is when it's not activated, and this is when it activates. As you can see, the sky gets, like, the blues gets deeper, they're more contrasted. All the colors actually get more contrasted, and that is absolutely magical in my opinion. That's why I use polarizing filters so much. It can make a boring daytime look way, 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 way more epic. Now, there are a few other types of filter. Let's see what they do. So another way filters can change your life is through long exposures. And let me explain. You might want to have the crowd blurry in daytime, or cars passing by blurry. And those babies, ND filters, what we call them, neutral density, are basically cutting out the light. Look at that. I'm gonna put it in front of it, and ooh, everything gets darker. You see? And what it means, if everything gets darker, the beauty of it is that you can have a shutter speed way, way, way lower. Now, with a lower shutter speed, your objects are gonna get blurry when they are moving. So for example, if you're shooting a waterfall, you'll be able to shoot at 1 second, 2 seconds, and all that, and get the super smooth water flow. Or if you're in the city, you can do local exposure looks in the full daytime, and that is also very interesting. Now, there is another thing that I tried to do the other night, but I think I did not expose long enough. It was about 2 minutes, 3 minutes. I exposed with a ND filter on like that. It was simply having the clouds move, and it basically paints out the whole sky in funny colors. It's very beautiful effects. If I did not achieve it, because I don't know yet, I didn't edit the photo. All right, so by now you already have three ways you could be using filters to your advantage, and how they're gonna completely change your photographer's life. It's gonna help you try different things, shoot differently, think about a new creative way of shootings. But it's not over there, because you might be asking me, hey Pierre, why are there so many different filters? What's the number mean? Why is there, like, transparent filters? What do they even do and all that? I'm just gonna give you a few extra tips. I know it was supposed to be only three ways, but let's add a few. Let's go, let's do it right now. We're gonna pretend we're changing scene. All right, so the few other filters you can be using are basically UV filters. UV filters are doing nothing except protecting your glass. So if you have a very expensive lens and you don't want to damage the front element, scratching it, letting it down and all that, this can save you. Personal story, I had a 1740 Canon on, I think it's not purely straight here. I had a 1740 on my Canon 5D Mark II in a backpack one day. The backpack ended up being open for some reason. The whole camera dropped on the platform and bam, shattered. And what I was super happy about is that actually this shattered, the glass of the UV filter and not the lens. So happy. Well, I mean, I did bend the ring and it was screwed on for like 2 years on the lens without being able to be removed, but that's a different story. Totally saved my lens. So that's one way you could be using UV filters. Now you might be asking also, what do the ND numbers mean? So I'm just gonna give you a super quick brief ND numbers. For example, ND8, ND16, ND1000, 100,000. Actually means the number of light stops it's gonna stop. Haha, that's funny. Okay, so for example, this is an ND8. It's gonna stop 8 stops of light. As you can see, it's great, it's very practical. ND filters are not just for long exposures, they're also for video when you wanna keep the shutter speed at double the frame rate of what you're shooting with your camera. Guys, if you're interested in video stuff, I can do other videos. We can talk about it in different videos. Just let me know in the comments. I have no clue if you're interested or not. So, when you're gonna buy your ND filter, you're gonna look at how many stops of light you want to be cutting out. If you're trying to do like super long exposure in daytime, look at stuff like ND 1000 or 100,000. It's gonna make everything like super, super dark, practical. One last type of filter I just wanna mention, I don't have it with me because I'm traveling, it's usually big and bulky. It is basically a gradient ND filter. What it means is simply that one side of the filter is basically dark and the other side is transparent and it degrades slowly. And you can see that photographer was using it the other day to get cool dark skies and very well lit foreground where it's not the sky. It allows you mainly at sunsets to not overexpose the sunset and still have the landscape. Landscape photographers know those and use them all the time, super practical. All right, last thing I want to touch on is simply if you're trying to buy filters, watch out for the quality, that's gonna have a huge impact, okay? If you get super cheap filters, they might have color cast, which means your colors are, everything's gonna look out maybe magenta or maybe greenish, and that gets really weird. For example, I've got Polar Pro filters right here that I use on my drone, as I mentioned in my gear video. That's funny. Now I got those, which are, they call it the quartz line. They're totally new, and I've been trying them for the past month and a half, and I can tell you there's zero color cast. Those babies are absolutely incredible. And there is a little hack if you really want to save money, is to buy stop-down ring, which is this baby right here. Super simple, you just put it on your lens and it's gonna bring basically, for example, from 82 millimeter down to 72 millimeter, which means, as I mentioned in the gear video, you just buy the biggest filters that you need for your lens and then you just buy adapters that will step it down. Super practical, save your money as much as you can. All right, I realized this was way more than just three ways. I actually give you a bunch of tips on filters. I really wanted to share that with you. It was a huge struggle with me when I was younger in photography. I was like, oh, I don't wanna carry big filters. And as you see those landscape photographers with like massive square filters. I really didn't want to carry that. I had it in the bag, I hardly ever took it because I don't know if you're lazy, but I'm kind of lazy sometimes. And if I can avoid having to take something out of my bag and putting it on the lens and setting it up correctly, I totally do it. Now, when you have screw-on filters, like I was showing you, this is way more practical. So yeah, I've put a bunch of filters in the description. You can check them out if you're interested. They're not cheap, but wow, I've been testing them. They're absolutely amazing. Now, with that being said, guys, I'm gonna go back in the car. I think I'm kind of melting. It might be like 41 degrees Celsius right now, which must be like over 100 Fahrenheit. And well, Trina might be melting in there too. Let me know if you're using filters too, which one you're using and how you're using them. I'm super curious. Maybe if you have photos, come hit me on Instagram, show me the pictures you took with your filters. And with that being said, guys, have an amazing day. Oh, I totally messed up my ending, guys. I was supposed to ask you, leave a big thumb up for that video. Make sure you share it with your friends. Sharing is super important for me. Really helps the channel grow. So if you think the content is worth it, share it with your friend, your family, your pet, everyone. And remember, hit that notification bell after you hit the SUBSCRAB button. Whew! That heat is really killing me right now. So I'm gonna get back in the car and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.